My name is Julia, and in this video, we are going to talk about labels. Label is a classifying phrase or name applied to a person or a thing. Let's talk about labeling customer segments. First, begin with defining the persona of your customer. Who are they? What jobs do they need to get done? What gains do they wish to see? Often, especially with tech startups, management gets wired and unjustifiably involved with the product. Such a mentality assumes that customers exist to buy. That is false. The correct perspective is to fully understand that companies exist for customers. So, the product is secondary. Primarily, it is all about the customer. Also, it helps to know as much information about the audiences as possible. It tells who, specifically, will be interested in the product. This simplifies the process of crafting a marketing strategy which aims to reel in the right audience. Once you have broadly defined your ideal customer, dividing the collective into segments helps create customized and more targeted advertisements to entice prospects and increase conversion. To create segments, it is beneficial to look for similarities between different customers. This method is called clustering, and naming these clusters is called labeling. The segments can be created based on age, location, sex, or income. Can each customer be grouped? No. Some outliers will exist that do not agree with the schema of any cluster. These extremities are common. Labels are important in clustering. For example, you can create clusters in an organization to predict which employees will be most likely to leave. So, the dataset can have variables such as time spent in the company, number of projects, salary, satisfaction, and promotion to predict who will leave. Once you have determined a similarity measure and the number of clusters to be created, profiling and plotting the data can be simple. The scatter plot will display the clusters. By assigning labels to these clusters, you will assign meaning. For instance, the cluster displaying observations with the highest salary in the organization can be labeled as executives, with the medium salary as managers, and the lowest salary as employees. These labels can be further attributed for the purpose of characterization. It is probable that the highly paid executives will have stayed with the organization the longest, express a high level of satisfaction, are good performers, and less likely to leave. The character profile of an executive employee teaches us what a loyal employee looks like. On the contrary, an employee who is low salaried, is burdened with more than 3 projects, has only spent 6 months in the organization, and expresses a low level of satisfaction, is more likely to leave. These labels help name and assign meaning to a group of people and even further characterize them. This can be a terrific way to organize the diverse customer base and target them with more specific marketing paraphernalia. Let us know in the comments about the labels you have created to segment your customers. Give us a like if you found this useful and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Thank you for watching.
Data Science Dojo, data science for everyone.